What's up, y'all? Pretty we left off on what happened last time. Well, was it was some it was a comeback. And
Did you fix the pipe?
No, Joe. Oh, yes, I'll do.
Great.
See?
Everyone.
Almost.
Okay.
Great. My social account's been on fire lately. But this is going to put it over the top. My fans, the chosen ones, are going to love
what's up,
the
number one watcher?
That.
How you
what
been
do you
doing?
Mean? Oh, that wasn't just for my self-confidence. I recorded what you said on my phone so I could post it. The entire world needs to hear you say Chosen is the greatest.
You're actually the worst.
Sorry, I already stopped recording. Can't take back what you said. Good luck in the qualifying match. Don't bro it.
But we last left off on the greatest, the comeback. You know, cause well, we was doing a comeback, y'all. And what else? I mean, we whooped Dom and a couple of people. What's up, number two? But yeah, we finished Dom. We whooping Dom and all that. Now we in the tournament. Now we doing the tournament, y'all. And this is part 8. Welcome to WWE 2K23. My Rise. We will see if Brock Anderson will have the best career or the worst career. We don't know. We don't know. It's up to y'all. It's up to y'all. That. I say we'll have the best match, but if y'all think he gonna have the best or not, put it in the comments. Put it in the comments. I'm sorry, y'all. But I just came off of work. But yeah, put it in the comments. Put it. Put it in the comments. Say what you gotta say. Like, think what you wanna hear. It's like Sami Zayn. But yeah, we just have to see. Look at this jabroni. Like, look at this. Like, look at this. El Rado. Like, El Rado. Like. I know his name. Oh, sorry, y'all. What type of name is this? Like. The Andersons. Will. Ah, damn it.
Yeah.
And he's done. The jabberoni is done.
The Apex tournament is finally here. How are you feeling?
A bit jet-lagged from the flight, but I'm sure once the bell rings, the adrenaline will take over and I'll be fine.
Why is this tournament so important to you?
This can rebuild my image. I want to stick it to the WWE.
This is a high-profile event where a successful showing would go a long way to rebuild my image. And of course, I wouldn't mind beating a few current WWE superstars in the process.
Got it. So, this is the part where you explain the format of the tournament.
You really need to start doing your research. The tournament's participants are split into two groups. Each group's wrestlers face off in round-robin singles matches. Wins are worth 2 points, draws one, and losses, zero. The winners of the two groups face each other at the Japan Dome to determine the tournament champion.
And that's a big deal?
Yes. I've competed there a handful of times earlier in my career, but only in opening matches. The final of the Apex tournament will be the main event at the Dome. So yeah, I'd say that's a big deal.
This is part 8. Yeah, I think. Yeah, this is part 8. the doctor says. Take the jury on the doctors. You are guilty on the pastors. Let's go! Street, street! Thank you. It was easy. It was easy. Too easy, y'all.
I saw you won your first match, too.
Obviously. But I'm not here to talk about the tournament. I have some feedback on the video you did for me.
So, what video?
You mean the video you recorded without my knowledge where you tricked me into saying all those lies about you?
Yes, that's the one. After listening back to it, your performance was lackluster and uninspiring. I didn't believe anything you were saying.
That's because I didn't believe it either. You're not better than me. And if I get the chance to face you, I'll prove that.
Sure. I mean, don't get me wrong. The video still put up big numbers. After the edit, of course.
I watched it, and the fart sound effects you added were a bit much. Can you delete it now?
And then you would pay me the lost ad revenue? Don't think so. Besides, I want it right for when I do a follow-up video after I win the tournament. It's all part of my plan to build my following even bigger and conquer the wrestling world.
That's my goal too. Minus the lame social media content.
I've seen your feed. That is lame. Anyway, only one of us can get to the top. And look, already had his chance. It's my time now.
We'll see.
You're off to a good start so far. It's going to be a tough few weeks to get to the end of this tournament and come out on top.
Any advice on how to survive?
You showed you could tough it out in the British Rules Tournament. So, do more of that?
Thanks, I guess.
There is one way you could get some extra rest, but it would go against tradition. Typically, you participate in tag matches on tournament off nights, but you could skip them. So, you want to earn the respect of the Japanese fans and show them you have fighting spirit? Or tell PWJ and the fans to shove it and rest up.
I'm not taking any shortcuts, and I'm certainly not going to risk disrespecting the Japanese fans. So I'll honor tradition and do the tag matches.
Good call. I wouldn't have wanted to be seen with you if you chose the other option.
It's like my punk, it's like he's still dark.
I see new golden in my eyes, I knew it was all. It takes me down. I never did anything about you. And I never did it for true. And I never did it for true. It better be perdido.
What is cooking?
I saw you won your first.
See, every time we do this, we gotta go back to
it.
And that's just crazy. I don't know why.
Any advice?
Thanks.
There is.
I'm not taking any
good.
That's crazy. We gotta do a tag team, bitch. Ricochet. Okay, y'all. The tag team match. In the corner. With the claymore kick. Oh, nah, get your ass. Get down. Spiritual shot. Thank you.
If I'm understanding the tournament format correctly, we're nearing the end of the round robin portion, and after a draw against Ricochet, you're now 1 point behind Finn Balor, headed into your final group match, which happens to be against Balor.
That's right. So if I want to win the group to get to the finals and main event, the Japan Dome, I need to beat Finn. A loss or another draw, and I'm headed home empty-handed.
Well, hopefully you've at least picked up some cool souvenirs while you're here, so it wouldn't be completely empty-handed.
The only souvenir I care about is the Apex Tournament Trophy. But to earn that, first I need to beat Finn, which will be no easy task. He's a top WWE superstar, so I'm sure he'll have some extra motivation to not be upstaged by me.
If you beat Finn, it's looking like Chosen is a lock. Sorry. It's looking like Chosen's going to win Group B, so you'd face him in the finals.
Chosen is tough. Chosen is not a threat.
I'm not surprised. Chosen's arrogant, but he can back it up. But if I look past Finn, there will be no finals. So that's my sole focus right now.
Alright, y'all. I might have to redo this. Let me see. If I hope they'll let me. I just want to give him one. Damn it, it won't let me. Maybe next time it'll let me. Voices in my head, they cancel me, they understand. My bad, y'all. If y'all keep hearing some stuff, I'm shaking. I'm moving my head. I won't fit in with.
Thank you.
Fucking fin. Bitches. Come on. No! I reversed it! No! They cheated. Get out. this. That's how y'all do it. That's how y'all win. What's the wok? It's cooking.
I'm working on my victory post for after I win the tournament final.
You mean after?
Do you think fire emojis is too much? Or will it really drive home the point that I'm on fire?
You ever hear the expression, don't count your chickens before they hatch?
No. Why would I not want to count my chickens? How else would I know how many I have? That is dumb.
Whatever. Point is, let's see how the match turns out before you start celebrating.
I already know how it's going to turn out. I went undefeated in the group stage while you had to win your last match just to barely clinch your spot in the finals. So, I have way more chickens than you.
We'll see.
You're really not getting that.
Also, your old friend Shawn Michaels sent me a DM that he'll be watching our match. Probably wants me to be his next rock.
Don't get involved with Shawn.
I don't think Shawn will be interested in signing you after I embarrass you in the ring.
Now, who's counting their chickens?
How is ya? I need a drink. Okay, the entire world wrestling will be watching the finals to see how far you come. So no pressure. You got this. Even if you don't, well, you are on the right track. But is that still pressure, y'all? It feel like that's still pressure. Like it feel like it's still pressure.
Thank you.
Let's do this. The Five Spirit has taken you this far. Let's carry you all the way to the top. Attempt to defeat the Chosen One by any resource. We won, y'all. Like I said, what's up, number two watcher? Yeah, we won. Superstar Slave WWE is your Royal Rumble. Oh, phew. Where you going, Becky? That no why Van Damme. Thank you. no match. He was no match. He was no match, y'all. This is too much. Dog, I get it. Don't tell me this is a battle warrior. Cole. No, that's they ain't Cole. That's Chase. Thank you.
Congratulations. So how does it feel to be the hottest thing in pro wrestling since Paul Heyman's undershirt?
First, it's great running into you, Justine. Second, I'm going to need a minute while I erase that image from my brain.
Heyman's words, not mine. Send him on my podcast. Any chance you'd like to come onto the show? Talk about everything you've been through since you left WWE?
Don't get me wrong. I'm a huge fan of your podcast. Tavish and I listen whenever we can. I'm just not sure I'm ready to start telling my story yet.
Oh, come on. Your run in the Apex tournament was incredible. And that's exactly what my listeners want to hear about. What do you say? I'll go easy on you.
No time like the present, I guess. Let's do it.
Great. Let's set up a time ASAP.
I think we got a cutscene, y'all. Chase.
Hey, heard you on Justine's podcast. Loud and clear. Talking in code again about a platter of stale ribs you threw in the trash. Clearly up to your old tricks.
I have to be totally honest. I have no idea who you are.
Name's Chase. Had a stint at the PC recently? Or you might even know me as Ribby. Ring any bells? Oh, don't play dumb with me. You know exactly how it played out. I never got a contract offer because you told Shawn Michaels to stay away from the ribs in catering, which was clearly code to avoid me.
Wow. Listen, I'd love to stay and clear this nonsense up, but Cole Quinn called into my podcast appearance to talk smack, and now I've got to go give him a receipt.
Oh, I know. I was listening. I liked the part when he said you haven't changed one bit since your mocap meltdown.
We'll see about that. Good luck, Chase. I hope you get to the bottom of whatever deranged conspiracy theories you were talking about.
Oh, I doubt that very much.
Mm-hmm. Just like he said, he's real. He's real, y'all. But we about to whoop him, though. After we whoop him, we'll end it. I don't know. I gotta see. After a couple more matches, we'll, you know. Excuse me. He came out the back with a super kick. He came out the gate with a super kick. Come out the gate with a Claymore! Who is this? I don't even know who this is. Oh, this Chase. Thank you.
Thought you could just blow me off, huh? Not so fast.
It's not polite to show up without an invitation, Chase. Guess they don't teach that in deranged mascot school.
A good one. But I think it's about time you start taking me seriously.
You want serious? How about a match tonight? And if I win, you leave me the heck alone.
You sure you don't want to catch your breath first? I'm not interested in Cole Quinn's leftovers.
Nope. You'll actually be doing me a favor. Two wins in one night is exactly the kind of buzz I need right now.
Very confident for a WWE washout. Okay, tough guy. If you've got so much gas left in the tank, why don't we make it a no DQ match?
Even better.
I'm tired of Chase, bro. We're gonna be chasing. I'm gonna try my best to break every bone in Chase's body.
Thank you.
y'all.
I have another big opportunity for you to generate some buzz in a different part of the world.
I'm gonna have to start paying you commission.
What are you thinking? 25%, 30, or maybe 20% plus a cut of all future royalties?
I was kidding.
Right. Me too. Anyway, I could get you on a show in Mexico teaming up with Hector Flores. WWE sending him to Lucha Magica for a special appearance, and the local promoters are looking for a hot commodity to team up with him.
I don't really cross paths with Hector much when I was in WWE, but I've heard he's a good guy. And if not, well, at least it'll be some good exposure. I'll do it.
All right. And the flight's on you, since, you know, I'm not getting paid for any of this.
Didn't know you were going to be here, too.
Same. I had enough of you after the Apex tournament. Thought I could be look-free for a while.
Don't call me that.
Okay. Look.
Gentlemen, you're going to have to learn to get along better, since you'll be teaming together tonight.
What? I thought you said Hector Flores was my partner.
Hector is your partner. Both of yours. It's a trios match. You know, Lucha Libre tradition.
You gotta stop doing stuff like this, Tavish.
I knew you'd throw a tantrum and not want to do it, which is why I didn't tell you. So I'll stop doing this stuff when you learn how to get outside of your comfort zone.
Are you two done yet? I don't want to do this either, but I'm not over here crying about it with a weird old wrestler who follows me around everywhere I go.
Okay, I see your point about him, but it's too late to change the match. Just put your issues aside and work together. You don't have to be best mates or anything. Deal?
It will be good content for my socials, I guess. So, I'll do it.
Fine. But just this one match. That's it.
So, like y'all see, so as y'all see, as y'all can see, there's a trio match between me, Hector, and the chosen, you know, against, I don't know. But let's talk to Hector.
Hey, Hector. I was happy to be teaming with you down here. Until I found out we were also teaming with Chosen.
It will be fine.
I've known Chosen for a while. He can certainly rub people the wrong way, but he means well.
I will give this a shot. I don't know all about it.
Maybe you're right. I'm willing to give this a shot if you are, I guess. But enough about Chosen. What have you been up to lately?
It's been an interesting time for me in WWE. I turned down the chance to join Los Lotharios, and they've been messing with me ever since.
Ha, faction trouble. I had my fair share of that in WWE, too. You're better off on your own.
Yeah, in this case, at least. Anyway, I'm happy to see you doing so well now. I had heard you were having a hard time after WWE. Someone said you got into a fight with Sami Zayn at a video game shoot?
Yeah, that happened. But it's all my past, and like you said, things are going well now. So let's keep the positive momentum going and get the W tonight. Sound good?
Sounds good to me.
Still to come. Special guest Hector Frazier, Brock Anderson, and Chosen. Team together in SI Detroit Action. With the fat dude. Don't tell me he with the fat dude. No. I knew it. Not crow, but you gotta give it an 8.
Thank you.
Thank you.
I do one more.
I'm sorry for getting you too involved in all this. That attack was my fault.
You didn't know that was going to happen. And now, this is our fight too. We need to get revenge.
But putting Chosen's mask on the line is taking things too far. I'm not a masked luchador, but I understand how important it is. Losing your mask can destroy your career. It could tear you apart both professionally and personally.
So I've made the decision to call off the match.
If this is our only chance at revenge, then I'm willing to take the risk. We are doing that much.
What about your image? Your social media following? Your plan to be the best in the world? You could lose everything while we have nothing at stake.
It's what you would do, right?
I don't know.
Before you went to WWE, the answer would have been yes. I actually looked up to you back then.
You? Looked up to me?
Yes. You are so confident in everything you did. But then you failed in WWE. And not because management held you back. You headed yourself back because you lost that belief that you could succeed in any situation. You made excuses and blamed everyone instead of just doing the work. But I'm not going to make the same mistake.
I see. That's a lot to digest there.
Are you sure about this, Chosen? What if we lose?
I can overcome any setback. That's actually another lesson he taught me. I mean, look at how terrible things got for him. Yet, here he is. I mean, he threw everything away. Like, it got really, really bad. He was a plumber at the airport.
Okay, I think we get the point, but how about we just don't lose?
That works for me.
All right, let's do this.
You've had some time to think about what Chosen said. Were you surprised that he looked up to you at one point?
Yeah, I was. I just thought he didn't look up to anyone. Would have meant a lot hearing that, and why he thought my WWE run didn't work out. I'm not sure if I agree with everything he said, but it was interesting to get that perspective.
This mask versus hair thing is a huge deal in Mexico. It's actually called a lucha de apuesta, which means match with wager.
Someone finally did their research. Like you said, it's a tradition that goes back a long way in Mexico, so I take it very seriously. I might have had my differences with Chosen, but he's putting so much on the line by agreeing to this. So, I'm going to do everything I can to not only get payback against Legado de Lotharios, but also protect his mask and legacy. We owe him that.
Alright, y'all, like I said, you see what's online. You see if the mask was in the hair. Then we gotta cut that bitch off. Then we gotta cut that hair off. Let's take this. We gotta get this W. Should I end it right here? All right, child, I'm gonna end it. Well, let me see what he wants.
Have you heard what Noam Dar's been up to lately?
I've been a bit busy winning matches all over the world, so no. I haven't had time to keep up with Noam Dar or NXT UK at all.
Well, you're in luck, because I have been watching, and I'm really good at concise, informative recaps. Noam Dar is now both the NXT UK champion and holder of the Heritage Cup, which, reminder, is defended under British rules. Recently, he issued an open challenge for anyone to face him for both of his championships.
Not bad on the recap, but could have gotten to the point quicker. That open challenge is intriguing.
If you're interested, I can put some feelers out with NXT UK.
Alright, y'all. I think for this one, we'll be heading to NXT. I don't know.
I am interested in answering the open challenge, but don't bother reaching out to NXT UK. I have a different plan. WWE likely won't play ball with me after how things ended. So what if I showed up unannounced?
Huh. Are we doing an invasion?
Yes. Yes, we are.
Okay. What happens if you win?
I haven't thought that far ahead yet. I'll play it by ear.
NXT UK and Heritage Cup champion Noam Dar has laid down his open challenge yet again and is waiting for anyone in the locker room to step up and answer it.
So far, no one has been able to defeat the dual champion.
Hold on. We have an unexpected trespasser here.
Do your job, security.
We're not focusing on what's going on to not give any publicity to someone who's unauthorized to be here.
It looks like Noam Dar wants to let him stay.
Then I guess we can say his name. The man formerly known as The Lock is trying to stage some kind of publicity stunt by showing up here at NXT UK.
I may no longer be a WWE superstar, but that doesn't stop me from answering open challenges. So I'm ready to do this if you are.
Noam Dar has informed me that he will accept the challenge as long as the match is contested under British rules.
As far as we know, The Lock has never competed in a British rules match, while Dar specializes in this style as Heritage Cup champion.
I'll do it. Let's go.
Brilliant move by the champ. A guaranteed way to send this unwanted visitor home, beaten and embarrassed.
Yeah, right.
We're going to have a former WWE superstar competing for two NXT UK championships. This is insane.
Please, for the love of God, Noam Dar, just win this match.
After a shocking turn of events, the former WWE superstar, once known as The Lock, looking for an early pin. Gets his shoulder up right before two.
He might have been putting the cart before the horse with that pin, but it was worth a try.
And that failed to hit the mark.
Crash landing powerbomb.
You have to question what kind of malintent is behind a powerbomb with that much force.
The foot DDT.
Hoisting up their opponent.
Wow, what a spinebuster.
Exploder suplex. He's getting a little battered now.
No need to panic. He's still swinging.
Power slam. An unyielding showing of authority. No two ways about it. Just punched him right in the mouth. Relentless. Right to the face.
My God.
Just a continuous rush on Noam Dar here.
Dar on the wrong side of every exchange lately.
Able to give him the slip. German! Just pure dominance.
Placed in the corner.
Things went from bad to worse. This superstar's got something in mind. Something big, something painful. Superplex!
And there's more?
With a Falcon Arrow Chaser.
Two! And he kicks out at two.
He really thought that was it.
He's running into some problems here, guys.
Yeah, he is sparing no energy right now.
Just deadlifting right there. The power.
Superhuman.
take much more of this.
I don't want to say he's done, but I can hear the fat lady warming up. Incoming.
Crash landing. Powerbomb.
Just a continuous rush on Noam Dar here.
Dar on the wrong side of every exchange lately.
Knee lift. Waist lift.
Yeah, raw power there.
Spine buster.
And we see him take yet another shot to the body.
A knee right to the face.
He's reeling, slowly getting up.
Seen a human being tossed like that.
Ooh. Oh, perfect kick.
And Noam Dar sidesteps.
A counter answered by another counter.
He's executing on his plan perfectly.
His offense is second to none at times like this.
The foot DDT.
Knew what was coming there.
Oh, my goodness. Kick to the spine.
Bionic elbow.
Right to the forehead.
Ooh.
Power bomb. Oh, knee to the face.
Oh, boy. He's stalking him. Watching for an opening.
Future shot.
Dar's being carefully measured now.
Has him hooked.
Crossroads!
Noam went down in a heap.
He's getting up, but there's danger in front of him.
Uh-oh. Batten down the hatches.
F5! Thunderous!
And we are done here.
And his eyes are piercing through the opposition now.
Extra luster behind that kick. Able to avoid any harm there.
Continuing to work on their opponent's arm.
Oh, man.
And Armbreaker takes him down.
He's getting a huge boost right now from all those chants and cheers.
Oh, my goodness.
From the ground up.
Superhuman.
Hooked up.
Great power.
Inverted suplex.
Might only be Hart keeping Noam Dar in this match.
Yeah, this is not good.
You don't say, Saxton.
He steers clear of contact.
Hoisted up. Here we go. F10 facebuster.
Punched him right in the mouth. Relentless.
Enough already.
He's got to know he's in harm's way here.
Has them hooked.
Crossroads.
Will that be it? Will that be enough?
Cover. Two.
A non-contracted, disgruntled former employee just walked in here and captured not one, but two NXT UK championships. This is a dark day in WWE.
It is, but more importantly, how do we move forward? Is the former Lock back in WWE now? This is pure, absolute chaos of the worst kind.
I don't know what's going to happen either, but maybe the new champion can shed some light on his next move.
If you haven't been keeping up with my career since I left WWE, I've been busy rediscovering what made me the next big thing and the Lock in arenas all around the world. But one thing's been missing. I haven't had any hardware to show off. That changes now. Wrestling fans everywhere, this NXT UK Championship and that Heritage Cup are coming to an arena near you.
Are you kidding me? Is he stealing the NXT UK Championship and Heritage Cup?
It certainly looks that way. Again, where are the police or the Bobbies or whatever the hell you want to call them here.
Now you can add assaulting security and a referee to the rap sheet.
Somehow, a dark day in WWE just got even darker.
I might as well cancel the rest of the show. Just shut it all down after that.
Okay, anyway, here, part 9. No. Yeah, part 9 might be in a few minutes, in a couple of minutes. So, anyway, here, part 9 might, like I said. Okay. You seen what happened. We took the NXT UK Championship and the other one. So, The comeback is finished. Well, nah, I don't think it's finished. But yeah, we just took the NXT thing. So, like I said, peace, Mike. All love y'all. This is Young Sean signing out. May peace, may God be with you. And deuces.